द वेरी इन्फॉर्मिंग एंड वेरी यूजफुल डिबेट दैट वी हैव हैड ऑन द मोशन हैज आई एम श्योर गिवन गवर्नमेंट अ ग्रेट डील ऑफ फूड फॉर थॉट. मेनी सजेशंस हैव बीन मेड विच आई हैव बीन थैंकफुल टू फाइंड आर वेरी लार्जली इन अकॉर्डेंस विद गवर्नमेंट्स ओन आइडियाज ऑन द प्रॉब्लम्स विच डिवेल्युएशन हैज थ्रोन अप एंड आई हैव नो डाउट इन माई माइंड दैट वेन वी सेट अप अ suitable machinery for bringing about increased possibilities of consultation between the government and parliament in these matters we should be able to push things forward to a satisfactory stage. I am glad that my honorable colleagues the ministers of food and supply and commerce and industry have been able to participate in this debate because most of those issues which have been raised in the course of the debate are issues which are concerned with the ministries which they represent and they are naturally able to speak with fuller knowledge about them. I wish in the little time that I have at my disposal this evening to confine myself to certain broad considerations which honorable members have raised in the course of the discussion. I am fully in agreement with the suggestion made by various speakers that what we need today at the stage that we have reached is not so much more proposals as more willingness, ability and readiness to implement proposals. The question of implementation is really the most vital question that we have to face today. The more I think of the economic problems with which the country is faced today, the more I feel that at bottom they are not really economic problems in the sense of technical economics, but they are really problems of administration. You look at any of these problems which are causing us worry and anxiety in these days, you will find that deep down they resolve themselves into problems of efficient and honest administration. Now the question of administration is bound very closely with the other idea which has been suggested by several honorable speakers, namely the idea of coordination. When honorable members speak of coordination, they are thinking apparently only of government at the highest level that we here represent. I beg to suggest to the House that from the point of view of coordination, what is more important is cooperation at a much lower level than what we represent. as far as the center is concerned, there has been a suggestion made from various quarters of the house that what we seem to be suffering from as far as the central government is concerned is lack of coordination between the various ministries. For some months now we have been working with an economic committee of the cabinet in which all the ministers who are concerned with the economic side of administration meet often, sometimes twice a week, to consider jointly the economic problems that affect them all. And since I am perhaps very directly concerned with the working of that committee, I think I have some right to say that we have made a certain measurable degree of progress in the matter of coordination at the center. But as my honorable friend Dr. Shyama Prasad Mukherjee mentioned, the question of coordination is equally important as between the center and the states. Some of our greatest difficulties arise from the fact that under the kind of constitutional system under which we are working today, policy is laid down by the center, but the execution of the policy is in the hands of state governments. If there is not enough coordination, if there is not sufficient attempt on the part of the two agencies of government to get together and work out their problems jointly, we shall not be able to make the progress that we all desire. I do hope in the days which are immediately ahead of us, as soon as the Constitution has come into force, we probably shall have at our disposal a more effective machinery for this purpose. Sir, in the speech which I made on the motion before the House, I placed before honorable members the program that the government have in mind in order to meet the difficulties created by devaluation. If I may take the most important of the difficulties that we have to face, the most important directions in which government have to move, I would mention three particularly. Now I come to the main bill. It goes without saying that a change is needed in the patents law because our last act is of 1911. 1911 is a period when this country was industrially not at all developed. It is very necessary to see how our law should be modified in order that the patents law is not detrimental to consumer interest and is not prejudicial to the industrial development of the country. If the law stands against these two, then it has to be changed. Therefore, an attempt has been made to change the law.